Hey, Julian Kras here, and this little thing claims to boost your microphone with clean gain so that you can get low noise recordings with dynamic microphones, even on cheaper recording gear. Let's have a closer look. This is the Triton Audio Fathead, and it's a preamplifier that goes in between your dynamic microphone and your recording device. It uses phantom power provided by the recording device to amplify your microphone signal. This way you do not have to crank up the gain on your recording device that hard, which in turn will result in a lower noise floor. This can be very useful if you do have noisy preamps in your recording device and you want to lower the noise created by the preamps. Before we start to dive deeper into this device, I quickly want to mention that the Fathead will only work with dynamic mics because it blocks all the phantom power going to the microphone. That's not a problem because condenser mics typically have a pretty strong output signal already, and you simply do not need any additional gain for low noise recordings. So the Fathead is tailored specifically for the use with dynamic and ribbon mics. With that out of the way, let me show you how this thing works. First, I will record myself talking into a Shure SM57, which is a dynamic mic, connected to my Zoom H5. This is me talking into the microphone. I have the gain of the Zoom H5 set to level 4.5, and as you can hear, this is a pretty low recording level. And now I will add the Fathead between the H5 and the SM57. I'm now talking into the mic the same way I did before, but as you can hear, the signal is now much stronger. And that's essentially all the Fathead does. It amplifies the signal from the microphone with its built-in high-quality preamplifier. Of course, I couldn't resist and made a few tests to find out by how much the Fathead is actually amplifying the signal from the microphone. Triton Audio states that the Fathead will provide at least 27 decibels of gain. In my tests, I found that the provided gain depends on the audio device you use the Fathead with. Attached to my H5, it delivered nearly 33 decibels of additional gain, and on my Roland audio interface, it delivered about 31 decibels. So I think it's safe to say that in practice you will usually get around 30 decibels of gain. That's actually a substantial amount of additional gain the Fathead is providing, and because of that I only need to set the gain on the H5 between level 4 and 5 when recording dialogue. If I wanted to record the audio at the same amplitude without the Fathead, I would have to turn the gain on the H5 all the way up to level 8. This of course will bring out the noise of the preamps on the H5, and I will show you this in a second, but first let's have a listen to the noise floor of this recording with the Fathead connected. Now I got the Fathead disconnected, and as I told you, I had to turn the gain on the H5 up to level 8 to achieve the same recording level. This is the sound you're going to get if you hook up a Shure SM57 straight to the Zoom H5, and you might already notice the higher noise floor. Have a listen. And now let's directly compare the noise floor of the recordings with and without the Fathead. I think this comparison speaks for itself. You can clearly hear a big difference in noise. And that's because when you're connecting the Fathead, you're essentially substituting the noisy preamp in the H5 with a much better performing preamp in the Fathead. Again, I couldn't resist to do some more tests to find out more about the noise performance of the Fathead to compare it to the H5's built-in preamps. For that, I measured the equivalent input noise. This value is an indicator of noise performance of a preamplifier in an audio device, and it can be used to compare the noise performance. As you might know from my previous videos, the Zoom H5 has an EIN of -120.5 dBU. The Triton Audio Fathead has an astonishingly low EIN of roughly -130 dBU. When I tested this the first time, I thought I made a mistake, but I triple-checked the measurements and the Fathead is simply that good. By the way, I did say roughly -130 dBU, because the noise performance, like the provided gain, changes a bit depending on the audio recording device you use the FATHEAD with. Okay, what exactly do these numbers mean? Well, you can simply subtract the numbers from each other and you will have the difference in noise you can expect in a real recording situation. As I already said before, if you connect the FATHEAD to an audio recording device, you essentially substitute its noise performance with the noise performance of the FATHEAD. So when connecting the FATHEAD to the H5, the noise performance improves by about 10 decibels. That's a very noticeable difference, and that's what we heard in the noise floor comparison before. I also wanted to see if the FATHEAD changes the sound in any way. The frequency response graph provided by the manufacturer is pretty much useless because the axes have no label on it. So I tested the frequency response of my H5 with and without the FATHEAD on my own. And I did not see any significant change in frequency response. Of course, only because the frequency response is identical, it does not necessarily mean that it will sound 100% identical. But it shows you that there is at least no obvious change in amplitude over the audible spectrum. And from my listening tests, I can also confirm that I did not hear any difference in sound when using the FATHEAD, besides the reduced noise floor. Now, all this time I talked about audio performance of this thing and I did not even go over the build quality, so let me quickly do this now. When you buy the FATHEAD, it's delivered in a small pouch inside a little tube. The FATHEAD itself is barely larger than a standard XLR plug, and its housing is made out of metal and feels very sturdy. When connected to other XLR connectors, the connection feels solid and locks nicely into place. All in all, I'm very happy with the look and feel of the FATHEAD. So to conclude, this small device can provide a big boost to your mic signal and in turn lower the noise floor of devices with noisy preamps significantly. If you do work with dynamic microphones and you encounter preamp noise in your recordings, the FATHEAD is a cost-effective and easy-to-use solution. Okay, that's all for now. If you like these more technical reviews, subscribe to not miss out on any future videos, and I see you in the next one.